somewhere out west. They're working on a cure. I think what really impressed them was the fact that I didn't turn into a monster.
I'm taking you with me.
It was stressful initially, I think, because, you know, the game is so important to so many people and you want to stay true to that representation of it. And they did such a wonderful job in the game. So, you know, you want to stay true to it, but at the same time, having that kind of artistic freedom was incredibly wonderful. It was a really lovely set and a wonderful space to work, thanks to all of the cast and Neil and Craig. Yeah, it was beyond enjoyable and then slightly stressful because, you know, you're interpreting someone that is a very beloved character to a lot of people.
I love the games and I love the character. I fell in love with the character very quickly. But we get to explore a lot of the moments before the inciting incident, before everything goes wrong and the whole world goes to crap. We get to see them be a family for a little while. And that was a lot of fun. I mean, those moments just when everything is still normal were a lot of fun and also very important to the story to establish, you know, what this little family looks like when they're not fighting for their lives.
But I guess one of the first things I asked Craig, who was our creator, you know, how true to the characters of the game do you need us to be, or is it our interpretation, or what are you looking for? And he was like, no, it's a new interpretation. And that was a relief, because you can then kind of go, okay, great, I'm just can make this my own. And you know, even in the costume and the, you know, she's much older and Joel's much older, like all of that stuff, so there was a freedom in that. I wasn't anxious about it. And also because, you know, Craig's such a fan of the game as well, you knew that they were gonna do it justice. They were gonna do it right.
One of the great thrills of my career, because even when I first met Marlene on the page, before I auditioned for the video game, I was deeply moved by her power, by her strength, by her courage to make some of the decisions that she had to make and to stand firm in that. So all of those things I felt were carried into the HBO adaptation. And then when I got there to be able to, step into her boots, actually walk and talk as her, and rely on my instrument in the total was a new modus operandi for me that I had a little bit of nerves when I first stepped into it.
You're not gonna scare us.
Scared him?
This is sort of separate, but I learned an American accent for the show, and I learned that American accent by cursing, essentially. Yeah, you're right, she takes no shit from anybody, and I love that. And now when I do an American accent now, like, if I ever need to make a phone call that's, like, important, I do an American accent because it helps me not take shit from anybody.
Really?
Yeah. It's amazing how it really, like, shifts into... Anyway.
So I would think here that, like, an English accent is so disarming to Americans.
Really?
It would get you what you want quicker.
Interesting.
And you could use that American accent to put an English person in place, maybe.
Exactly. Exactly.
Exactly.
If she so much as twitches, don't.
You were very grossed out by them.
I was grossed out, and I'm like, I like scary stuff.
Yes.
But the clickers were a little too much for me.
I found them sort of beautiful.
They were beautiful.
And that's what was scary, actually. I think the beauty that they had was what was terrifying.
The kind of like monstrous floral nightmare.
Yeah. And the fact that it was like the whole fungus cordyceps infection is based on science. Like, it theoretically is possible. And that's what was like also terrifying, I think.
You've come this far, and you know what's out there.
I think so. We come from the same home.
Birthing place.
Yeah, we're birthed from the same world of violence.
Yeah, exactly. And that's HBO too, and like
Carolyn Strauss was our boss, and no one could ask for a better one. But it is sort of a bond that we have, because for me that was the biggest job that I'd ever gotten.
And it was the first one.
First job that you ever got. And neither one of us would be here if it weren't for Game of Thrones.
Mm-hmm.